And welcome back to Dominican Rendezvous. Thank you for joining. Today, I want to talk about the biggest mistakes not to make. The biggest mistakes not to make. Many mistakes are generally made because you have not taken the time to adequately research what it is that you're doing. And in this case, we're talking about researching the various aspects of buying property in the Dominican Republic and property that you may use for agricultural purposes, for farming or small-scale farming. Researching is more than just looking at people's YouTube channels, such as Dominican Rendezvous. Research is more than just Googling online and Googling online. You need to take time and scrutinize every part of your business idea, every part of your business plan and your operations. As I've said before, I'll say it again, talk to people who know and understand this business and understand the business of agriculture and farming and in these things that you might be interested in. Glean from their insights, glean from their wisdom, glean from their business experience. Find out what you can learn from them. And certainly choose people that you can trust so that you don't get taken to the cleaners, so to speak. There's some things that you need to know in this process of doing your research. You need to know about land. You need to know about soils. You need to know the legalities that are involved in the purchase of your property, as well as in the running of your business and the operations of your business. You're going to need, if you're into agricultural, you're going to need to know about food safety and food safety issues. You're going to probably manage people. People management is another thing that you need to study and learn about and have some experience with if you have that opportunity. Climate, the geography of the land and the area where you are planning to purchase. The equipment, the machinery. You have to have some basic knowledge of these things. How to market your product. How to package your product, how to harvest your product, how to plant your product, how to seed your product. All of these things are going to be critically important, and you're going to have to take your time and research them. The second thing I would say is you must have, or to put it a different way, a lot of people don't have enough money to do what they need to do. They just simply haven't budgeted it correctly. There are hundreds of people who are out there that will tell you, oh, you can start an operation, you can start a small-scale farm with little to no money. You'll find YouTube's videos on that. You'll find articles are written about that. But hey, that's not necessarily true, and I don't think it's the best way to go forward. Many fall for that trick. You have to wise up and not be caught up in the misinformation that is out there. Startup costs and emergency costs, an emergency budget, are not always cheap. It's going to take some money. So don't fall for that trick that, oh, it's not going to cost you a lot of money. Ask yourself, do you have enough money to cover the unexpected occurrences that may happen? Unexpected occurrences like crop damage, natural disasters, which are frequent in the Dominican Republic with the hurricane and the tropical storms. Are you having enough money set aside to pay insurance and insurance premium for crop damages? We'll talk about that in another video. You need to make a budget. Sit down, think carefully, make a budget. What is it going to cost you for electric? What is it going to cost you for taxes? What is it going to cost you for telephone? What is it going to cost you for the upkeep and the maintenance of the place and a whole bunch of miscellaneous budgetary items that you need to consider if you're going to go forward with this process? The third thing I would say is this. You need to know the regulations. Make sure that you have someone who can give you legal advice. A legal advisor who can help you look into all the legalities, all the laws pertaining to what it is that you are doing and to your possible operations. Ask yourself these questions as you think about these legalities. Is it safe what you're doing? Is it legal what you're doing? What are the regulations on land use? What are the regulations about storage? What are the environmental concerns that may be present in your neighborhood or in your locality? Those are some things that you need to know about. The property codes. the municipal codes? Do you need a license for this, that, or the other thing? How are you going to sanitize and sanitation issues that may be present? These are things that you must think about as you continue to move forward in this process of perhaps buying property, buying land, making a getting a villa, and maybe doing some farming on your property. You need to know before you start these things. And so lastly, fourthly, I'll say this. Just simply make a plan. Sit down, write it out, make a business plan. And when I say write it out, it also could mean typing it out on the computer as well. But make sure you have a nice business plan, a business plan that states what your goals are, what your mission is, what you're looking to accomplish, and then a budget as well. And be realistic. This takes time. This takes effort. And again, you're not going to find all this information just by watching Dominican Rendezvous. You're not going to find it by watching other YouTube channels or just Googling. As I said in the beginning, you're going to have to talk to people. You're going to have to get out there, hit the pavement, and find out this information on your own. And there are people who are willing to help you. You need to find those people that are going to help you, people that you can trust in. I hope this helps. It's extremely important. Thank you for joining today. Please take a moment to subscribe to the channel, Dominican Rendezvous. Also, hit that notification bell. Would love to have you watch the videos as soon as they are released. And lastly, for any of you who have comments or questions or suggestions, please feel free to contact me by email. I prefer the email route more than the comments on the video, but the comments on the video are obviously read and are appreciated. Thank you very much. From me to you, Dominican Rendezvous.